Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel, Double E Lectures. I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi, and the topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines, Current and Voltage Relationships. In this short lecture, we will deduce the current and voltage relationships in DC machine when it is operated either as a generator or as a DC motor. In order to provide clarity in deducing the current and voltage relationships in DC machine, both the cases, that is DC generator as well as DC motor, are dealt alongside. So the first one is separately excited DC machine. These are the representations of separately excited DC machines. The first one would be dealt as DC generator, and the second one would be dealt as DC motor. As you have already learned, the field windings of the separately excited DC machines are supplied by independent external source of voltage VF. The field winding resistance is RF, and the current in the field winding is IF. EG and EB are the generated EMF and back EMF in the armatures of the separately excited DC generator and motor respectively. Moreover, VT is the output terminal voltage of the separately excited DC generator, while in case of DC motor, VT is the input terminal voltage. The armature resistance is RA and the armature current is IA. IL is the output current from separately excited DC generator or input current to the DC motor, as the case may be. Furthermore, the directions of current IL are represented by red arrows. Clearly, one may notice that the current IL would be identical to the armature current IA for both separately excited DC generator as well as DC motor. The field current IF can be calculated by dividing field voltage VF by field resistance RF for both separately excited DC generator as well as DC motor. Further, in case of separately excited DC generator, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by subtracting the armature voltage drop IARA from the generated EMF EG. On the other hand, in case of separately excited DC motor, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by adding the armature voltage drop IARA into the back EMF EB. Now, shunt excited DC machines. These are the representations of shunt excited DC generator and motor. The shunt field winding resistance is RSH and the current in the shunt field winding is ISH. EG and EB are the generated EMF and back EMF in the armatures of the shunt excited DC generator and motor respectively. Furthermore, VT is the output terminal voltage of the shunt excited DC generator, while in case of DC motor, VT is the input terminal voltage. The armature resistance is RA and the armature current is IA. IL is the output current from shunt excited DC generator or input current to the DC motor, as the case may be. Moreover, the directions of current IL are represented by red arrows. One may easily notice that the current IL can be found by subtracting the shunt field current ISH from the armature current IA, in case it is a shunt excited DC generator. On the other hand, the current IL can be found by adding the shunt field current ISH into the armature current IA, in case it is a shunt excited DC motor. The field current ISH can be calculated by dividing the terminal voltage VT by shunt field resistance RSH. Moreover, in case of shunt excited DC generator, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by subtracting the armature voltage drop IARA from the generated EMF EG. On the other hand, in case of shunt excited DC motor, the terminal voltage can be calculated by adding the armature voltage drop IARA into the back EMF EB. The next one is series excited DC machine. These are the representations of series excited DC generator and motor. Here, the series field winding resistance is RSE and the current in the series field winding is ISE. EG and EB are the generated EMF and back EMF in the armatures of the series excited DC generator and motor respectively. Further, VT is the output terminal voltage of the series excited DC generator, while in case of series excited DC motor, VT is the input terminal voltage. The armature resistance is RA and the armature current is IA. IL is the output current from series excited DC generator or input current supplied to the series excited DC motor, as the case may be. The red arrows points out the direction of current IL. Clearly, one may notice that the current IL would be identical to the armature current IA for both series excited DC generator as well as series excited DC motor. Besides, the series field current ISE would also be identical to the armature current IA for both series excited DC generator as well as series excited DC motor. However, in case of series excited DC generator, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by subtracting the armature voltage drop IARA together with the voltage drop in series field winding ISERSE from the generated EMF EG. In contrast, in case of series excited DC motor, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by adding IARA together with ISERSE into the back EMF EB. Now consider short shunt compound DC machines. These are the representations of short shunt compound DC generator and motor. The shunt field winding resistance is RSH and the current in the shunt field winding is ISH. On the other hand, the series field winding resistance is RSE and the current in the series field winding is ISE. EG and EB are the generated EMF and back EMF in the armatures of the short shunt compound DC generator and motor respectively. Furthermore, VT is the output terminal voltage of the short shunt compound DC generator, while in case of short shunt compound DC motor, VT is the input terminal voltage. The armature resistance is RA and the armature current is IA. IL is the output current from short shunt compound DC generator or input current to the short shunt compound DC motor, as the case may be. Moreover, the directions of current IL are represented by red arrows. One may easily notice that the current IL would be identical to the current ISE in series field winding for both short shunt compound DC generator as well as short shunt compound DC motor. Further, the current ISE can be found by subtracting the shunt field current ISH from the armature current IA in case it is a short shunt compound DC generator. On the other hand, the current ISE can be found by adding the shunt field current ISH into the armature current IA in case it is a short shunt compound DC motor. In case of a short shunt compound DC generator, the shunt field current ISH can be calculated by dividing the voltage at this particular point by shunt field resistance RSH. The voltage at this particular point can be determined by adding the voltage drop in series field winding, that is ISE-RSE, into the terminal voltage VT. Thus, ISH would be equal to the terminal voltage VT plus voltage drop ISE-RSE divided by RSH. In a similar fashion, in case of a short shunt compound DC motor, the field current ISH can be calculated by dividing the voltage at this particular point by RSH. However, the voltage at this particular point can be determined by subtracting the voltage drop in series field winding from the terminal voltage VT. Thus, ISH would be equal to the terminal voltage VT minus voltage drop ISERSE divided by shunt field resistance RSH. Besides, in case of short shunt compound DC generator, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by subtracting the armature voltage drop IARA together with the voltage drop in series field winding ISERSE from the generated EMF EG. On the other hand, in case of short shunt compound DC motor, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by adding the armature voltage drop IARA together with the voltage drop in series field winding ISERSE into the back EMF EB. Now, keeping into observation, the direction of the currents in shunt and series field windings of the short shunt compound DC generator, as represented over here, it is worth notable that the series field strengthens the shunt field, and therefore, this particular short shunt compound DC generator is said to be cumulative compound. On the other hand, keeping into observation the direction of the currents in shunt and series field windings of the short shunt compound DC motor, as represented over here, it is worth notable that the series field weakens the shunt field, and therefore this particular short shunt compound DC motor is said to be differential compound. Now consider the case of long shunt compound DC machines. These are the representations of long shunt compound DC generator and DC motor. The shunt field winding resistance is RSH and the current in the shunt field winding is ISH. On the other hand, the series field winding resistance is RSE and the current in the series field winding is ISE. EG and EB are the generated EMF and back EMF in the armatures of the long shunt compound DC generator and motor respectively. Furthermore, VT is the output terminal voltage of the long shunt compound DC generator, while in case of long shunt compound DC motor, VT is the input terminal voltage. The armature resistance is RA and the armature current is IA. IL is the output current from the long shunt compound DC generator or input current to the long shunt compound DC motor, as the case may be. Moreover, the directions of current IL are represented by red arrows. One may easily notice that the current IL can be found by subtracting the shunt field current ISH from the series field current ISE, in case it is a long shunt compound DC generator. On the other hand, the current IL can be found by adding the shunt field current ISH into the series field current ISE, in case it is a long shunt compound DC motor. However, the series field current ISE would be identical to the armature current IA for both long shunt compound DC generator as well as long shunt compound DC motor. Moreover, the shunt field current ISH can be calculated by dividing terminal voltage VT by shunt field resistance RSH for both long shunt compound DC generator as well as long shunt compound DC motor. Furthermore, in case of long shunt compound DC generator, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by subtracting the armature voltage drop IARA together with the voltage drop in series field winding ISE-RSE from the generated EMF EG. On the other hand, in case of long shunt compound DC motor, the terminal voltage VT can be calculated by adding the armature voltage drop IARA together with the voltage drop in series field winding ISE-RSE into the back EMF EB. Once again, keeping into observation the direction of the currents in shunt and series field windings of the long shunt compound DC generator as represented over here, it is worth notable that the series field weakens the shunt field, and therefore this particular long shunt compound DC generator is said to be differential compound. In contrast, keeping into observation the direction of the currents in shunt and series field windings of the long shunt compound DC motor as represented over here, it is worth notable that the series field strengthen the shunt field, and therefore this particular long shunt compound DC motor is said to be cumulative compound. So this is all about the current and voltage relationships in different sorts of DC machines. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.